The translation of the artistic intention from the analog and binary language is transformed by the program's code into a transgressive mixed reality. Thus, media art literally lies between real and virtual, and between arts and computer science, between theory and practice, between two established disciplines, art and science, a place in between arises. Media art. At the end of the 80s, our interest was to connect the body and the senses with artistic interfaces to explore the knowledge of the body. In the last 10 years, our interest shifted to knowledge interfaces to handle the complexity of digital data. With this new body experience and this unfolding knowledge discovery tools, we gained a new perception based on interactivity. The aesthetics of interactivity is based on process of thinking while acting. We call it knowledge arts, Wissenskünste, because the former viewer becomes an active participant in the artistic production. To bridge the gap between art and computer science, with the Mars Lab, we created a transdisciplinary environment for research and development as one of four departments in the Fraunhofer Institute. To do this was only possible through huge research grants, which we could acquire, and where our work was evaluated by computer scientists and awarded in the art and design world. So, imagine a cube. I'm sure in your mind it looks like the figure on the left, but not so with the computer. Six faces, 8 points in space, on the move by floating point operations in a digital transformation. The platonic solids amongst the cube are a class of completely regular body and are named after Plato. Platonic solids are solutions to the problem of the physicist Joseph John Thomson. Figuratively speaking, he describes this problem as distributed n electrons on the surface of a regular body. Thomson investigated in 1881 the behavior of moving electrical charges, and this led to the concept of electromagnetic mass. He discovered that the electromagnetic energy behaves as it would increase the mass of a body. Looks like this. Under the conditions of cybernetics, the former image or object migrates in a myriad of geometric constellations. The perspective as symbolic form is dissolved. Movement as a cultural form combined with constant change of viewpoint is a cybernetic paradigm. And there is sometimes even dust in these images by these transformations. I would remind you of the question, what is interactivity? It is a correlation between people, machines, and interfaces in order to exchange information. Interaction can be described as process of information through performative acts of knowledge. In the context of communication between a human and an artifact, interactivity refers to the artifact's interactive behavior and structure as experienced by the human user. An artifact's interactivity is best perceived through use. The reception is action-oriented and can create new knowledge. Michelangelo has depicted the moment of the creation of Adam with the touch of the hand, the detail in the center of the picture. Metaphorically, we transfer the idea of creation to the interface and the moment of touching interactivity of man and machine. Interactive artworks are virtual machines that produce instances of presentation based on real-time input. Both the artwork and the interactor are data performers. There's a process of experiencing interactive artworks and less a purely pictorial perceiving. Access to the interactive process comes through the creative or artistic interface that is a producer of difference, so to create new knowledge within a reversible thinking space similar to maybe Warburg's Denkraum, the space of thought. And I show some examples of projects which will undermine this. Using the data platform goggles, the viewer can enter the architecture of mind of the four philosophers, Joseph Weizenbaum, Wilhelm Flusser, Marvin Minsky, and Paul Bourdieu, and their thesis discussed until present concerning the future of our culture. The subject of this installation is a metaphor of virtual space as a stage and the abilities of the viewer moving in the world of ideas of the four protagonists to broaden the beliefs of our senses through reading by body. By this vision of network public space for meetings and conversations, we promote an artistic image of contemporary internet culture. Project was done in 1991. Until now, it was not possible to stroll through the thoughts of others, as media theorist Derek Kerkhoff commented on the virtual reality project. We see the navigator in the virtual space. So the viewer is inside the image, and part of the scene shows the four houses of the philosophers, so these spaces of thought. The navigator moves through, and with this navigation, he sets up the own agenda of capturing the ideas in this virtual environment. As the technology today is not existing anymore for the exhibition in the Russian Center, we built an interface, which is an analog interface, which is based on stereo slide viewers, so like keyhole views, one can examine you get an idea of the original view, which is a three-dimensional view because of the stereo goggles, and so it comes back what is lost. With liquid views, we talk about memory, self-reflection, and the knowledge of the body. Touch is the interface to the virtual world here. The virtual mirror of Narcissus, as we describe liquid views, is a simulation of water in which the viewer's reflection is portrayed as in real water. Fingertip on the touch-sensitive screen releases waves and causes a self-portrait solved. The interactive installation translates the parable of Narcissus in a visual and intellectual reflection of the relation of image and effigy. This reflection is not only a poetic attempt to face the memory and forgetfulness, it is also a technical evoked experience of presence which shows a fit onto the self from the outside. Strongly enlarged, the virtual reflective face of the viewer looks from a big projection screen in the background into the space and onto the next spectators. Liquid views very clearly shows the character of interactivity. The observer is observing him or herself simultaneously while acting, and because of the installation's dispositive, the interactor is watched by the others while watching him or herself. shown in more than 30 countries, and it was interesting to discover the different, on the one hand, the different reception in these different cultures, but as they were based on a very deep growing myth of metamorphosis, it was interesting to get like 30 different approaches, like 30 different answers to one question. Another floating project is Energy Passages, which is a public sitting space installed for 4 weeks in front of the House of Literature in Munich. Hundreds of catchwords taken from daily newspaper appear as visual information flow, projected on the screen, simultaneously spoken by artificial voices. As soon as passersby select the word, semantically related links become visible in the information flow, which can also be experienced as an audiovisual echo. Due to interaction, the visitors write a living newspaper by means of their personal choice. During 4 weeks, runtime of the installation in the center of Munich, the system builds up a collective memory of the visitors' interactions. It confronts the most frequently used words of the newspaper with the most often chosen words of the visitors. You see, the model of the installation is a website, so to say, where you can simulate the selection of the words like the visitors in public space did during the installation. And you see the archive of the visitor selection of words, which were measured and archived. The most used words in the newspaper during the 4 weeks were Germany, million, people. In opposite to the most words chosen by the audience, which were victim, love, and food. The difference of the use of language and meaning in mass media and the preferences of visitors became visible. This is exactly the same simple method today offered by Google Insight for Search, a statistic of searches which was used recently by economical scientists for nowcasting of the actual presence. So we had 4,000 visitors during these 4 weeks of presentation, and usually forecasting systems in Germany